There's this extraordinary effort to stop us documenting
fake news. The BBC is twisting the facts.
What? Did you say BBC is making things up?
Yeah, check out this video report on Xinjiang. They obviously didn't do a complete investigation. I guess the media forums are correct. BBC stands for Biased Broadcasting Corporation. They only report on China when they can make up some controversy, especially when it comes to Xinjiang.
I know how you feel, but calm down a bit and show me your evidence.
Entire culture, and it's
rebuilt. I know this guy really well. His name is John Sutterworth, and he'd done a lot of reporting on Xinjiang. He said that during his trip in Kuka, Chinese authorities followed his team, stopped them, and questioned its members.
We're turned back at checkpoints.
It's interesting to know the camera work the BBC used to portray his trip in Xinjiang. Their camera seems to be hidden and shooting from a very low angle. It's already putting bad ideas into our mind for what we are about to see.
The best way to figure out what really happened is to talk to the people on the scene.
Hello
again. Hello. Good to see you again.
我觉得没有依据。从他们来的第一天呢，我们就已经进行了正面接触，而且把他们的权利和义务也对他们进行了告知。采访的这个规则他们也十分清楚，所以我们不可能去干涉他带我们库车的这个采访活动的。
开始执法。
大家非常感谢您在这个情况还一直保持冷静和理性。
Wait, remember the guy trying to stop filming? Who is he?
Yes.His name is Jiang Yong, head of security for the factory. BBC's team made assumptions that Jiang was trying to stop them. But the real story is he doesn't speak English and just wanted to make sure what happened.
When I went out this door, I saw that they didn't wear a mask. He was in this position, just filming. He was walking this way and introducing him.他站在这个站在路边上，也就这样的拿那个手机在拍呢。我就问一下，你们是干嘛的？他立马把这个整个摄像机，包括他的手机就对着我。我一边往过去走，他就一边在拍。我说你们在干嘛呢？我还把那个手堵到他那个手机上，任何东西没有。你说你光说他说是他是那个啥记者团，没有表明任何身份。你说我是记者来。
He can take me at my word. I have not taken any footage of him or pictures.Of him, and he will not be seeing pictures of him on any of our reports.
But in the BBC's report, we still find him, Mr. Jiang.
The BBC report led me to believe it was the police, Chinese authorities, who stopped the filming. But in fact, it was Jiang who did that. The BBC report implies he had something to hide, but he was just concerned that the BBC didn't ask for permission before filming him and what he believed is private property. The BBC report is totally misleading.
The other thing is that in a lot of his reporting, Sutterworth seems to always find some type of confrontation where someone is blocking his team's filming.
Yeah, it's like they are deliberately painting a picture and China is trying to stop us from reporting because they are hiding things. To be fair to the BBC, they are not the only ones.A lot of the West media do the same, it seems. They claim to be fair and accurate, but in truth, they manipulate facts and don't report news, but try to influence feelings. Let's get back to the BBC report. In their failed investigation, they claim the forced labor is used in Kucha factory. Check out what the BBC calls evidence of forced labor. A Google Earth satellite image that was taken in 2019that shows people moving between buildings. The BBC said the buildings on the left is a Kucha factory where forced labor is happening. The building on the right are a vocational training center, something the BBC claims to be a camp.
But here's where they made a huge mistake. A local official told us that a vocational training center was once indeed located on this site. However,All Chinese in the center graduated before October 2019. The buildings on the right are now completely empty and the ones on the left were leased to the factory in March 2020. So Sadowa's sprawling labor camp doesn't even exist.
The factory gave us access to tour and asked us to show the full picture. Management said BBC's confrontational visit unsettled them. So we asked if we could talk independently to the workers, which the factory agreed to.
啊，我们自己来，自己干活那个想干。我的聊过那个病的，我的老那个婆婆也病了，所以我挣钱多多的挣钱，在这里那个好好上班了。
In general, the workers seemed happy to talk with us, and not one single person gave the slightest hint that they were working here against their will.
But the BBC seemed to be satisfied with their report about forced labor and camp without having even gone into the factory or spoken to any of the workers. In fact, it seemed to me that on its trip to Xinjiang, the BBC had just one mission, to prove that everything the China haters say is true.